Hello YouTube, what is up? It's your bowl of soup here, and we are here for another Gran Turismo 3 video. After doing that challenge with the Esperante on the Like the Wind, I wanted to see what other cars I had that can beat the race stock. And as you can see, we're using the rough CTR2. Lineup's a bit different from last time, not the most ideal. In fact, you can actually see I qualified for this, and I actually got first, thanks to slipstreaming this car. Because I know for a fact that if I didn't start in front of everyone, then I'd had no chance. I look at the acceleration of the 787B. I had to start in front of it. This B12 punted me there. Okay. So in the last race, I was using the Esperante, and the B12 was the fastest car there. But it had two flaws. One, it had massive wheel spin off the line, meaning didn't have a good launch off the line at the start of the race, and took a while to actually like accelerate out of the pit. That's what allowed me to catch up at the end. Here? No, the 787B, you can't rely on that same strat. It won't even pit twice. It'll actually only pit once on lap 16. And that's what made me think this wasn't possible. Then I had the idea. Wait, this Skyline is actually faster than the 787B on track. So if I qualify in first, thanks to the slipstream from the Skyline, and then somehow hold it off long enough for me to actually be able to slipstream it at the beginning of the race, and use that slipstream to catch up to the 787B, I can slipstream the 787B until it pits on lap 16. And after pitting, there will be only 4 laps left in the race, meaning it won't have enough time to close the gap between us before I finish the race. So I tried doing that, and as you saw from the results screen, I was successful. I didn't think this would actually work. I thought you had to have, like, the slowest possible, like, fast car in this race to catch up, but no. As you can see, by the second lap, I'm already in first. I just have to hold this and keep up with the 787B. As you can see here, I actually toyed the Skyline a little because, you know, the Skyline is actually the fastest car in this race. So what I was doing is letting it slipstream me. And, you know, we just slingshot past each other, trying to build a gap with the 787B. That really doesn't matter, though, because the 787B is going to finish second anyway, or first if I don't win, obviously. But, you know, as we already saw, I did win. But yeah, another challenge, which I didn't think was going to be successful, but it turned out to work out in the end. So yeah, just enjoy this race, and I'll be back at the end. And there you go, that's the race. But I do want to show something else before I finish up here. I just want to quickly prove that this car is indeed stock. Can't adjust anything because I have no custom parts. Assists are off. Change parts. Normal. Normal. Everything's normal here. Can't be naturally aspirated. This is a turbocharged car after all. No turbo kit. No intercooler. No transmission. No clutch. No flywheel. No LSD. Because I'm clean. No drive shaft. Normal tires. And no weight reduction. Or VCD. So yeah, that's all I wanted to show. And till next time.